Hey everyone, Trisha Hirschberger here, and throughout May, we're going to be taking a closer look at DIY and maker tech that's a little outside of our typical PC building world. So we wanted to start off with this video as a toe in the water before we wholly dive in. Today we'll establish some basic terms you should know if you're interested in getting started with the maker scene. First up, a Raspberry Pi is a tiny single board computer that can be used for any number of things, from a retro arcade emulator to a DIY weather station. There are so many accessories to choose from that you can make almost anything you desire. A retro Pi is when you add a classic gaming emulator built on Linux that can replicate the experience of playing everything from Super NES to an arcade from the 1980s. Then we've got the NVIDIA Jetson Nano and Arduino. Both are similar to the Pi, with the Nano being used for its amazing machine learning and AI abilities, and the Arduino boards, with their huge software and hardware ecosystem, are great for making toys, machines, and almost anything you can dream up. Now, when we talk about machine learning or AI, we're talking about a program that can learn and change without continued input from a programmer. The Jetson Nano is especially good at this type of work because of its physical specs. An Arduino board is a single board microcontroller that can be made to serve a function and can interface with others. People have made everything from a drone to a DIY Game Boy with Arduino. In Arduino, expansion boards that add functionality to the main board are called shields. Let's move on to 3D printing. Right now, armies of 3D printing enthusiasts are providing protective equipment for healthcare workers all over the world. So not only is it a fun hobby, but it is adaptable to the real world. Great for designing replacement parts, creating interesting sculptures or tabletop minis, and designing and prototyping your ideas quickly. Thingiverse is a super popular community and repository of submitted designs where you can find almost anything. The 3D printer is the device that actually prints in 3D using different types of plastic and even metals at the super expensive level, that it extrudes out a heated nozzle to create physical objects from a 3D model. Fun fact, I have also seen 3D printers that can 3D print food. Filament is the term for the material your 3D printer uses to physically create your designs. Each type has different printing quality, challenges, and best uses. Now, when we say maker, we mean a community of builders that seems to cover any hobby where you make something with your hands, and it's become a great resource for the budding nerd or geek. The DIY revolution of the last decade owes a lot to Maker and the culture of creation it's brought about. STEM stands for science, technology, engineering, and math. It's usually used to refer to these subjects in education and the job market. Therefore, a STEM toy is any toy that teaches about and provides practice in one of the STEM categories, while hopefully making it fun. Finally, when working in the makerspace, you may get into some light soldering, which involves melting a tiny droplet of solder onto the wire and surface in order to connect electronic connections and pieces to boards. Soldering is used all throughout the STEM world and beyond. A soldering iron is the mechanism that directs and melts the solder onto the correct surface, and solder is a conducting metal with a low melting point used for electronics. There you have it, Maker 101. You out there watching, let us know what experience you have in the makerspace. If you have a Raspberry Pi system running at home, or you're 3D printing D&D figurines, sound off. And remember to stay tuned throughout May, because we'll have more videos coming up looking at Raspberry Pi projects, STEM toys, and a whole lot more. Thanks for watching.